Okay, so our topic is physical and chemical properties of water important for life. So as I told you earlier, water has significant physical and chemical properties. Those significant physical and chemical properties play some essential roles in maintaining life on Earth. So in this section, we are discussing those significant physical and chemical properties and how those properties contribute in maintaining different functions or different roles in life. That's the idea. That's the overall aspect of the section. So in simple words, without water, actually there is no life. Without water, there is no life. So we can say simply, water is life actually. Look at this here. So water, you know, water is the most abundant molecule in living organisms. It is a vital inorganic molecule. It is vital means it's very important inorganic molecule. So water is important mainly due to two reasons. Clear? Water is important mainly due to two reasons. Two reasons are given in the syllabus. Clear? What are those? First is, it says water is a vital chemical constituent of living cell. Clear? Water is a vital, or that means very important chemical constituent of living cell. For an example, think, if you consider cytoplasm, its major component is water. Even inside every organelle, major component is water. Okay? So it is the most important or vital chemical constituent of living cell. Most of the other substances dissolve in water and exist inside the cell. In the cytoplasm or inside the organelles, other substances dissolve and exist. Okay? So remember the first reason why water is that much important, because water acts as a vital chemical constituent of living cell. Second reason is, we can say water provides a biological medium for all organisms. Water provides a biological medium. What does that mean? In terms of habitat, water provides a biological medium. That means, you know, water acts as a habitat for different living organisms. Inside water, on the surface of water, different organisms live. So in terms of a habitat, it provides a medium for organisms. Clear? And also water acts as a medium for reactions or metabolic reactions within the cell. Got that? Then that means within the cell, we say that main component is water. Most of the reactions or most of the metabolic reactions within the cell happen in an aqueous medium. Clear? That's why I said that water provides a medium for chemical reactions, so metabolic reactions for cell. Clear? Also, water acts as a transport medium. Clear? So in our body, also, blood in main, if you consider blood, main component of blood is water. All the other substances dissolve in the water of blood plasma and get transported. In our tissue fluid, main component is water. In plants also, main component of phloem is water. Majority is water. Xylem conduct water. So likewise, it acts as a transport medium. Look at this. In terms of different aspects, water acts as a biological medium. So we mentioned three such things. In terms of the habitat, water provides a biological medium. In terms of a medium for chemical reactions, it acts as a biological medium. And also acts as a, it is a transport medium. So likewise, in different ways, water provides a biological medium for all organisms. Remember, due to these two reasons, it is said water is very vital or very important. Clear? So while I am explaining this, you can go through your note. You can go through your note while we are explaining. Here, you can underline the important points. I will explain using that presentation. So this is your note. Go through the note. So those are given here. While I'm explaining, go through the note as well. Here it says, water is a vital inorganic molecule. Life could not exist on this planet without water. It is important due to the following reasons. These are the two reasons that we mentioned. So note here, in the first, it says water is a vital chemical constituent of living cell. That is essential. Why it is specifically living cell? If you consider dead cell, dead cells do not contain water as a constituent. Okay, dead cells even lack a cytoplasm. So it doesn't contain water as a constituent. Some cells, some dead cells conduct water within it. For an example, xylem vessel element is a dead cell which conducts water. So xylem vessel element has a lumen. Through that lumen, water is conducted. But water is not a component of vessel element. Clear? Because living cell is a water component. So remember these two reasons. And secondly, in the second reason, you have to memorize this word. Water provides a biological medium for all organisms. We said that in terms of habitat, in terms of a transport medium, clear? And in terms of a medium for chemical reactions, it acts as a biological medium. Okay, then it says, these physical and chemical properties of water molecule provides the ability to render the vitality. That means water vitality or the importance of water related to its physical and chemical properties. Now you can see these physical and chemical properties of water related to its structural nature. Physical and chemical properties of water related to the structural nature of the water molecule. So therefore, first we are discussing the structural nature of the water. Then we can discuss how that structural nature important in different physical and chemical properties. Okay, so describing the structural nature, it says, here it is said water is a small, polar, and angular molecule. Small, polar, and angular molecule. So it's like this. Then here you can see the structure of the water molecule in your note also. I will go through that presentation. Mang ay parakar presentation kata podda kyan. Eking api discuss. Now look at this. Here, this represents the structure of water molecule. You have this diagram on your note. You also have this diagram on your note. You can see, you know, water molecule consists of two hydrogen atoms attached to central oxygen atoms. Here, this is, imagine this is the oxygen atom. And these are the hydrogen atoms. So each hydrogen atom attached to oxygen atom by this kind of covalent bond. So this is a covalent bond between hydrogen and oxygen. Electrons are shared and form single covalent bond. Okay. So likewise, two hydrogen atoms are attached to oxygen by covalent bond. So it's a smaller molecule, has less molecular weight as well. Then it says it's an angular molecule. Look at this. So water is not a linear molecule. It has a specific angle like this. It is an angular molecule. In chemistry, you will learn how to determine the shape of the molecule. There's a theory as well to determine the shape of the molecule. There you will learn that. But until then, remember, water is an angular molecule. So with in between hydrogen, oxygen, and hydrogen, there's a specific angle. It is 104.5 degrees. This is fixed angle. Clear? Remember. So now you know it is angular molecule. Then describing the structural nature, it says, here water is a smaller molecule. Now you know that it's an angular molecule. And also, it is a polar molecule. Polar. What is the meaning of that? What is a polar molecule? What does that mean? That means in the water molecule, there is polarity. So what is the meaning of polarity? What is a polar molecule? That means within the polar molecule, there is a polarity. What does that mean? It says polarity. Remember, polarity is the uneven charge distribution. Uneven charge distribution among atoms of a molecule. Again, I am repeating, what is polarity? It is uneven charge distribution among atoms of a molecule. Clear? Simply uneven charge distribution within a molecule, polarity. How this uneven charge distribution happens? Look at this in water. Hydrogen atom is slightly positively charged. Here. This letter is delta. This letter is known as delta. Delta means slight or partial. Clear? That means balanda on hydrogen atom, there is a slight positive charge. So delta positive can term as partial positive. Partial positive. Clear? Slight positive or partial positive charge is present. On oxygen, there is a slight or partial negative charge. Clear? This letter is delta. Delta means slight or partial. On oxygen, there is a partial negative charge. Here also in the other side also same thing happens. On hydrogen, there is partial positive charge. On oxygen, there is partial negative charge. Remember, these are not fully positive and negative charges. And here, if you consider sodium chloride as an example, you know, when sodium chloride dissolves in water, sodium ions and chloride ions are separated. That means sodium plus and chloride minus ions are separated. Then we can see fully charged separation. Sodium plus completely and chloride minus completely. Clear? So those are full charge separation. But here, this is not a full charge separation. This is not full charge separation. Make a full charge separation. Uneven charge distribution. There's a partial positive charge or slight positive charge. And also there's a partial negative charge. That means slight negative charge. Got that? So likewise, having such uneven charge separation among atoms of a molecule is known as polarity. Likewise, here partial positive charge on hydrogen and partial negative charge on oxygen. That is polarity. Clear either. It is given in your note. You can read that. But we will discuss an additional thing. We can discuss how this polarity or partial positive and negative charges are formed. It is not biology. It is chemistry. Chemistry tika poddak matak karagattot meka therum araganna puluwan. You can easily understand using this. You can easily understand this using some chemistry. Matak karanna. You know about the electronegativity. Electronegativity. What does that mean? What is electronegativity? Mokadalama electronegativity kiyanne? Kiyanna balanna. What is electronegativity? Mataka. Electronegativity. I think you have discussed that in your O levels. Electronegativity discuss kala thiyona neida? Kohomada kiyanne electronegativity kiyanne? ලොකුට කියන්න ඕනේ නැහැ නිකන් පොඩි ඐඩියා එකක් ගන්න අදහසක් කිව්වොත් ඇති ඉලෙක්ට්‍රොනෙගටිවිටි what does that mean මෙහෙම කිව්වොත් එහෙනම් it is likeness to electrons likeness to electrons electronegativity likeness to electrons ඉතින් අපි සිම්පල් නිකන් තේරුම් අරගන්න විතරක් but how could we define අපි සාමාන්‍යයෙන් define කරන්නේ කොහොමද ability of an atom to attract bonding electrons towards itself the ability of an atom to attract bonding electrons towards itself electronegativity then here different elemental atoms have different electronegativities that means that here if you consider oxygen and hydrogen you know oxygen has higher electronegativity compared to hydrogen that means oxygen is more able to attract the bonding electrons towards itself compared to hydrogen therefore what happens mean this uneven electronegativities between oxygen and hydrogen forms this polarity look at this and here if you consider the arrangement of two hydrogen and if you consider the formation of covalent bond between hydrogen and oxygen we can explain it using this here you know this is the oxygen atom this oxygen atom collectively oxygen atom has 8 electrons matakana 8 electrons Among these 8 electrons, outer orbit of oxygen has 6 electrons. Outer orbit has 6 electrons. Imagine this electron, this electron is belong to. Let's say this electron is belong to hydrogen. May I the hydrogen? This is so. Let's say this also belongs to hydrogen. May then I the hydrogen? Then other electrons are belong to oxygen. Then you can see among those 8 electrons, 6 are found in this outer orbit. Among these 6 electrons of oxygen, 2 are unpaired. Here these 2 electrons are unpaired. There are 2 lone pairs. Pair which electrons? Pairs they got. Then you know these unpaired electrons involve in forming covalent bonds. Oxygen can share this unpaired electron with the electron of hydrogen and form a covalent bond. So here, this is the electron sharing. This hydrogen electron is shared with oxygen. Here also, hydrogen's electron share with oxygen and form a covalent bond here. Here also, it forms a covalent bond. So you know, these are bonding electrons. These are bonding electrons. Then due to higher electronegativity of oxygen, what happens? Due to higher electronegativity of oxygen, what happens? Oxygen is more able to attract these bonding electrons towards itself. Oxygen is more able to attract its bonding electron towards itself. Home attractor. Again, not only its electron. Oxygen, due to high electronegativity, oxygen is able to attract both of these bonding electrons towards itself. That means it attracts hydrogen's electrons as hydrogen electron ekak attract karana. It attracts hydrogen's electron as clear. Then hydrogen's electron, the electron of hydrogen is not belong to oxygen. It is belong to hydrogen. And this hydrogen's electron has negative charge. Electrons are negatively charged. That means due to high electronegativity of oxygen, what happens? Negative charge, which is not belong to itself, is attracted towards itself. Negatively charged electron of hydrogen is also attracted towards oxygen. Attracting extra negative charge towards oxygen. Then what happens? Due to attracting of extra negative charge towards oxygen, then it creates a negative charge on oxygen. Due to attracting of negatively charged electron of hydrogen towards oxygen, oxygen becomes negatively charged. But oxygen is not become fully negative. Oxygen is not fully negative. Why? This electron of hydrogen is shared. It is partially attracted. Because can compare to hydrogen, electron is attracted towards oxygen. Partial attraction. Therefore, it creates a partial negative charge on oxygen. Clear? Then, if you consider the hydrogen side, attracting electrons partially towards oxygen means, on the other way, hydrogen loses its electrons partially. Because electron is move more towards oxygen. Therefore, it's somewhat like losing the electrons from hydrogen partially. Clear? Due to losing of a negative charge, it creates a positive charge on hydrogen. Negative charge got amounting earlier again, it creates a positive charge on hydrogen. Did you get this? Clear? Likewise, due to higher electronegativity of oxygen, both bonding electrons, including the electron of hydrogen, are attracted towards the oxygen. This creates a partial negative charge on oxygen. So due to this attraction, it's somewhat like losing the electron from hydrogen partially. Therefore, it creates a partial positive charge on hydrogen. This is how partial negative and positive charges are generated. Okay. Did you get this? That is how water becomes a polar molecule. Then balan lamai okaran okkotom meka therunada kiyala. Clear the kiyala. This is okay. About the polarity. Okay, Dilamai, what again? There are nothing again, Mahari. Did you understand how polarity is generated in water? Yes or no? Okay, the response again. I'm not clear. Anita? Not clear. Senarita to. Anutra Rata, you know, Harry Dokurum, Noteru Taki and F. Yunata Toki Harry. Harry Munar Noteru Tante, for the type current Agala message, I drop in a section and section a balaganin. Harry Damona polarity. Okay, now you know the structure of the water molecule. It's a small, polar, and angular molecule. It is okay. Hari, then balan itu kuda mien. Then kau note take it balan deh. Itu underline kalau dia akan pelan balan deh. Here you can underline. Me, it says polarity is. You can see partial positive is me. Delta positive means partial positive. Delta negative means partial negative. Then it says polarity is an uneven charge distribution within a molecule. Then specifically in water molecule, oxygen atom is slightly negative, and slightly negative or partial negative. And hydrogen atom is slightly positive, that means partial positive. Weak attractions between the slightly polar hydrogen atom of one water molecule and slightly polar oxygen atom of adjacent water molecule are known as hydrogen bonds. Now we will discuss these hydrogen bonds. මේ මොකද්ද මේ කියන්නේ?
එන්න මෙහෙම. හිතන්න දැන් මෙහෙම.
Here then in liquid state or in other physical solid state also one water molecule, mainly we are discussing about this hydrogen bonds in liquid state. One water molecule is surrounded by adjoining water molecules. So let's say this is a central water molecule. හිතන්න මේ මෙතන තියෙනවා water molecule. I will draw the water molecule like this. Then on oxygen, you know there are lone pairs. That means unpaired electron pairs. Here, oxygen is slightly negatively charged. Hydrogen is slightly positively charged. Again, oxygen is slightly negative, hydrogen is slightly positive. Then focus on this water molecule. When it is in liquid medium, this water is surrounded by adjoining water molecules. Let's say here, this is a adjoining water molecule. It has, this also has slight negative charge on oxygen, slight positive charge on hydrogen. Again, slight positive charge on hydrogen and slight negative charge on oxygen. Balanne thodani. When slightly positively charged hydrogen and slightly negatively charged oxygen are found closer, whatever, the slightly positively charged hydrogen of one water molecule is attracted to, it is attracted to the this slightly positively charged hydrogen of one water molecule is attracted to slightly negatively charged oxygen of the adjoining water molecule. Right? Positive and negative charges are attracted. These are electrostatic attractions. Okay? So slightly positively charged hydrogen of one water molecule is attracted to slightly negatively charged oxygen of the adjoining water. These are electrostatic attractions. These kind of attractions in between water molecules known as hydrogen bonds. This is known as hydrogen bonds. Nithin meka hydrogen bond. Got that? Karane I parabalana what is how hydrogen bond is formed? It's an attraction. It's an attraction between positively charged hydrogen atom of one water molecule and the negatively charged oxygen atom of the adjoining water molecule. So generally these hydrogen bonds are these are intermolecular interactions. But intermolecular, again, inter means in between. So interactions found in between molecules can be termed as intermolecular interactions. Intermolecular interactions. Other molecules also have such intermolecular interactions. Normally, when the molecule size is smaller, then the intermolecular interactions become weak. Yeah. When the molecular size is smaller, intermolecular interactions become weak sometimes. In water also, these intermolecular interactions are comparatively weak. Not the weak intermolecular interactions, hydrogen bonds. But compared to some other intermolecular interactions found between smaller molecules, hydrogen bonds are much stronger. Right? Compared to some other intermolecular interactions found between small molecules, hydrogen bonds found in water are much comparatively strong. Generally, intermolecular interactions are weak, but compared to some other intermolecular interaction, this is comparatively strong. Generally weak, but compared to others, this is comparatively strong. Clear? Then, not only one, may several other water molecules can attract to several water molecules. Remember, here let's say there's another water molecule, another water molecule. This is another water molecule, surrounding water molecule. This also has possibly negatively charged oxygen and positively charged hydrogen. Negatively charged oxygen and positively charged hydrogen. Here also another intermolecular interaction or hydrogen bond can be formed. Likewise, one water molecule, focus on the central water molecule. Likewise, one water molecule can form four hydrogen bonds with surrounding water molecules. One water molecule can form four hydrogen bonds with surrounding water molecules. That means it's like this. This negatively charged oxygen also attracted to another water bond, like this. This is also water. It's slightly negative. This is slightly positive. Here, this is slightly negative. This is slightly positive. Here also, hydrogen bond can be formed. Can I try hydrogen bond can form? It is what? Similarly, another water molecule can be attacked. This is another water molecule. This is slightly negative, this is slightly positive. It's slightly negative, slightly positive. Here, another hydrogen bond is formed. So imagine, remember, these are hydrogen bonds. So how many hydrogen bonds can be formed by one water molecule with the surrounding water molecules? Four. So one water molecule will be attracted to four surrounding water molecules. These also attracted to surrounding water molecules. This is the formation of hydrogen bonds. Clear? So you can show this, you can see this in 3D space like this. 3D space then I drew only a diagram. Look at this. This is how these water molecules are arranged actually in 3D space. So as in the diagram, these are not fully positive and negative charges. Actually, these should be partial positive and partial negative. These hydrogen bonds are partial positive and partial negative. So here in this picture, they are given as fully plus and fully minus. It's wrong actually. They should be partial positive and partial negative. These bonds are hydrogen bonds. Clear? Question, is hydrogen bond comes under intermolecular bond? Yes, it's an intermolecular interaction or intermolecular attraction. Got that? Intermolecular interaction or intermolecular attraction. Intermolecular. It is electrostatic interaction. It's a positive and negative charges are attracted. It's not like a covalent bond. Then in forming this, electrons are not shared. Electrons share in any. It's a electrostatic attraction between positive and negative charges. Clear the balance? We know the polarity, then it says polarity. In water molecule, oxygen atom is slightly negative and hydrogen atom is slightly positive. Then it says weak attractions between slightly polar hydrogen atom of one water molecule and slightly polar oxygen atom of adjacent water molecule are known as hydrogen bonds. Specifically, we can say slightly polar hydrogen slightly positive. Slightly positively charged. Slightly positively charged. Within brackets, you can say polar hydrogen can slightly positively charged hydrogen of one water molecule. And slightly polar oxygen means, within brackets, you can say slightly. Negative. Slightly negatively charged. And oxygen to me is slightly negative. As you said, hydrogen bonds are more stronger than intermolecular bonds. No, hydrogen bond is also intermolecular interaction. Then molecules bonds had in an the other than ionic bonds, covalent bonds, bonds had in a puluan. Interactions. Monkey with in between molecules, there are intermolecular interactions. Interactions here. Even electrons bonds electrostatic attractions. Generally, intermolecular interactions formed between smaller molecules are weak. So hydrogen bonds are also weak. Hydrogen bond is also kind of intermolecular interaction. It is weak. Monkey way, I said that compared to other intermolecular interactions formed between smaller molecules, hydrogen bonds are much stronger. Intermolecular interactions hydrogen bond is much stronger. Hydrogen bond is also type of intermolecular interaction. Strong electronegativity very charge separation is hydrogen. Hydrogen bonds. These hydrogen bonds play a major role in maintaining all properties of water. Make emphasize these hydrogen bonds play a major role. Water has significant physical and chemical properties. those significant physical and chemical properties are related to the chemical structure of the water molecule. Now, more specifically, it is said, now you know, due to the chemical structure, in the chemical structure, we said it is a polar molecule. So, due to this polarity, water molecules can form hydrogen bonds with surrounding water molecules. Now, specifically, we can see these hydrogen bonds play the major role behind every physical and chemical property of water. Clear? Hydrogen bonding is my main role. These hydrogen bonds play a major role in maintaining all the properties of water. Clear? The properties of water arise due to attractions of different water molecules by hydrogen bonds. But specifically, when the water is in liquid form, its hydrogen bonds are very fragile. When it is in liquid form, hydrogen bonds are very fragile. That means they are not stable. They are weak. Compared to other weak intermolecular interactions, these are much stronger. But generally, these are weak. Therefore, they are not stable. Fragile. They are very fragile. So it further describes, it says, how it is fragile. Fragile can easily break down. Agala break down. Describing the fragility, it says, hydrogen bonds can form, break, and reform with a great frequency. These bonds can easily break down. Easily reform. Okay. So it forms, break, and again reform with a great frequency. If this bond is broken down, then this water molecule can quickly form another hydrogen bond with the surrounding one. Different water molecule will be attracted to this. Or this bond can be broken down and again be stable. Very fragile. We need this. We need that when you are discussing physical and chemical properties. Then, okay, the balance. Alright. So, shall we draw this hydrogen bonding, or shall we draw this diagram to show how hydrogen bonds are found surrounding water molecule? Make adi mara space. Utune space ka kila thi. Itna adi na make. Focus on this central water. Man den de akku nikam make itne ke andar main me dange ande pa. Focus on this central water. It form four hydrogen bonds in surrounding water molecules. Then okay me. When you read your resource book, when you read your resource book, you will get a contradiction. In the diagram given in your resource book, they have shown only three hydrogen bonds surrounding one water molecule. In the diagram given in the resource book, they have shown only three hydrogen bonds surrounding one water molecule. But actually, remember, like this, there should be four. As you observe in the diagram, there should be four. There's a mistake. It's a mistake in the resource book. Resource book in a diagram. It's a mistake. Actually, there should be four. In chemistry, in bonding, you will learn about these hydrogen bonds. So chemistry, hydrogen bond can be formed in different ways. A positively charged hydrogen can be attracted to negatively charged oxygen like this. Positively charged hydrogen can be attracted to negatively charged fluoride. Hydrogen bonds. Then positively charged hydrogen can be attracted to negatively charged chloride. Positively charged hydrogen can be attracted to negatively charged nitrogen. Likewise, different types of hydrogen bonds exist. Surrounding one water molecule, there are four hydrogen. Resource book, biology resource book, then draw this. හරිනේද? වැරදිනේ. හරි. හොඳට ඔළුව මත ඔළුවට දාගන්න එනම් hydrogen bonds play the major role may, in maintaining all properties of water. හරිනේ? ඕකේ. දැන් අපි යන්නේ ආගේ properties වලට. හරි බලන්න මේ තියෙන්නේ. Then there are four major properties of water which are important to maintain life on earth. Four major properties. What are those? These are major properties. First is cohesive behavior. Second is ability to moderate temperature. Water is able to moderate temperature. That's the idea. Then expansion upon freezing. And last is versatility as a solvent. Likewise, there are four major properties of water. Okay, there are four major properties of water. So we can see under each property, there are some sub-properties. So for an example, under cohesive behavior, there are two sub-properties. Okay, so what we are going to do here, we are going to discuss the properties or sub-properties under each of these major property and how those properties contribute in maintaining life on earth. Okay, they have different roles in maintaining life. That's what we are going to discuss. Okay, first we will move to the first property, that is cohesive behavior. Properties of water related to the functions. That's the topic. Properties of water related to functions. First property is cohesive behavior. Cohesive behavior. Under cohesive behavior, we said there are two sub-properties. Among them, first sub-property is has high cohesive and adhesive forces. We can say water has high cohesion and adhesion. Water has high cohesion and adhesion. Cohesion can also term as cohesive forces. Adhesion can be considered as adhesive forces. Okay, that's the first property. First, we will understand what is cohesion or cohesive forces. Here, look at this. In water, attraction between water molecules is known as cohesion. Imagine this is, here these are water drops, but these representing water molecules. Attraction between two water molecules is cohesion. Clear? Now, tell me. Tell me another name. Then tell me another name for cohesion. We said attraction between water molecules is cohesion. Tell me another name for that. What is the type of attraction between two water molecules? Attraction between water molecules, cohesion. What is the attraction between two water molecules? Element. Then up yandi. Intermolecular bond, intermolecular bond What is the name of the attraction between two water molecules? Annari, hydrogen bonds. Yes, hydrogen bonds. Clear, hydrogen bonds. What is cohesion? What are cohesive forces? Attraction between water molecules is known as cohesion. Or interaction between water molecules, cohesion. So what are these interactions between water molecules specifically? They are hydrogen bonds. That means remember, these cohesion or cohesive forces means simply hydrogen bonds. Again, hydrogen bonds. Clear? It was, what is adhesion? Adhesion refers to in water, adhesion refers to attraction between water molecules and another molecule or different molecule. Attraction between water molecules and a different molecule known as adhesion. Here, like this, mean attraction between water molecule and a different molecule, adhesion. Okay. This adhesion or adhesive forces can also be hydrogen bonds. Adhesion or adhesive forces can also be hydrogen bonds. Why? Because we say, hydrogen bonds can be formed in either of these ways. May only there have been the hydrogen bonds. So addition also can be hydrogen bonds. Clear? Addition with hydrogen bonds. If the other molecule has negatively charged nitrogen, chloride, or fluoride, or let's say oxygen of water attracted to positively charged hydrogen of another molecule, it is also hydrogen bond. So remember, then අපි කිව්වේ කොහොමද? Hydrogen bonds play a major role behind every property. Now, බලන්න cohesive forces are hydrogen bonds. Addition may be hydrogen bonds. Clean it then. Then මේ මොකද්ද උතර මේ water වල significance එක? බලන්න what may be the significance. මොකද්ද මේකේ significance එක? මේකයි significance එක මේ. Then adhesive forces and cohesive forces can be found in other molecules as but significance of water is these cohesive and adhesive forces are comparatively strong. Therefore, we can use the word high. Mean it has high cohesion and high adhesion. Why? Because we said these cohesive and adhesive forces are hydrogen bonds. We said that compared to other weak intermolecular interactions, these hydrogen bonds are much stronger. They are also weak, but compared to others, this is much strong. Therefore, we can say these are high cohesion and adhesion. I remember, so what is the first sub-property? Under cohesive behavior, water has high cohesion and adhesion. So both of these properties, on a property, now we can think, what is the role performed by water due to this property? Due to high cohesion and adhesion, water act as a transport medium within organisms. So what is the role performed by water due to high cohesion and adhesion? Water act as a transport medium. Make a transport medium. Now we will consider an example to understand this. Okay? How water act as a transport medium due to its high cohesion and adhesion. It's like this. Now consider an example. If you consider conduction of water and minerals in xylem as an example, we can understand this. Or else you can consider conduction of food, phloem sac within phloem. It is also okay. But the common example given in your syllabus is upward conduction of water and minerals in xylem. It is also known as ascent of xylem sac. Now using ascent of xylem sac, using conduction of water and minerals, we can understand the importance of high adhesion and cohesion. Imagine this is a part of the xylem. These are xylem cells. So we will, if we enlarge the diagram, it's like this. Imagine these cells are xylem cells. So what is the main cell type in the xylem? Xylem vessel element. Main cell type in the xylem is xylem vessel element. Imagine these cells are xylem vessel elements. These are xylem vessel elements. Then water conduct, water and minerals conduct upwards through these vessel elements. Water conduct upward through these vessel elements. So if we enlarge a small portion, imagine these blue dots represent water molecules. They conduct upward together with mineral ions like this through the xylem vessel elements. And if we enlarge small part of this xylem vessel together with its water, it's like this. Look at this. Here in this, within the xylem, these water molecules are attracted to each other. Imagine these are water molecules. These blue structures are water molecules. Water molecules are attracted to each other by this strong cohesion, and cohesion by hydrogen bond. Similarly, may water molecules are attracted to cell walls of the xylem vessel. Imagine this cell wall. Cell wall has a different molecule. So interaction formed between the water molecules and the cell wall is can be considered as adhesion. So this is how they are interacted. So due to this cohesion, when upper water molecules conduct upwards, due to cohesion, water molecules in the xylem are attracted to each other strongly. Then when upper water molecules move upwards within the xylem, together with the upper water molecules, these lower water molecules also move up. Somewhat like a movement of loops of a chain together. Chain like a loops, when upper water molecules move up, together with upper water molecules, lower water molecules also move up. Why? When upper water molecules move up, due to high cohesive forces or due to these hydrogen bonds of cohesive forces, lower water molecules are also attracted towards the upper water molecules. Then here, this water molecule will be attracted to upper water molecule due to these hydrogen bonds. Therefore, this high cohesion So hydrogen bonds important to transport water as a continuous column without separating water molecules. Clear? Then having high adhesion also contributed in maintaining continuous column of water. Due to high cohesion and adhesion, due to high cohesion, water molecules are attracted to each other. Clear? Meanwhile, water molecules are attracted to the cell walls of the xylem cells. Then these high cohesion and adhesion are important to transport water as a continuous column without breaking upwards. Okay. Then to understand this further, think the opposite. Anipathi itanda ithara mekata agala de. Anipathi itanda. Itanda if cohesive forces and adhesive forces of water are weak, then what happens? If cohesive forces and adhesive forces of water are weak, then what? When upper water molecules are pulled up, when upper water molecules are conducted upwards, these lower water molecules will not be attracted together with upper water molecules. Why? If these cohesive forces are weak, then these lower water molecules will be quickly separated from the upper water molecules. Then you have to agala separate now. When upper water molecules move up, lower water molecules will be separated. Then water can't be conducted upward as a continuous column. මේ මේ තංගල නුත් break කළා. මේවා weak නා. හරිද? දැන් තේරෙනවද කියපු කතාව? So due to high cohesion and adhesion, water molecules are attracted to each other. When upper water molecules move up together with that, lower water molecules also attracted upwards. Meanwhile, these water molecules attracted to cell walls of the xylem. Clear? හරිද කියන එක? හරිනේ උඩහන් ඉන්න. Then therefore water continuously move as a column. Column එකක් විදිහටම එක flow එකක් විදිහට උඩට යනවා. This continuous column of water bring dissolved mineral ions. Okay, mineral ions dissolve වෙලා එකත් එක උඩට යනවා. හරිද? Mineral ions then xylem conduct water and minerals due to this high cohesive and adhesive forces water conduct upward as a continuous column. Then mineral ions dissolve in this continuous dissolve in this water column and move together. So therefore, due to high cohesion and adhesion help to conduct water and minerals as a continuous column upwards. If cohesive and adhesive forces are weak, water molecules will be separated from each other. Then continuous column can't be maintained. Then same thing happens in our blood as well. Main component of blood is water. Clear? Main component of blood is water. All the then water molecules in blood also attracted to each other like this. Clear? They are attracted to each other, and also water molecules are attracted to walls of the blood vessels through adhesion. Then therefore, continuously water in blood plasma continuously move as a flow. Then all the other substances, cells, then other substances dissolve in this water in plasma and get transported together with water. හරිද ෆ්ලූයිඩ්ස් ට්‍රාන්ස්පෝර්ට් වෙන්නේ ඔහොම ෆ්ලෝයම් එකෙත් ඔය වගේ ක්ලියර් කතාව. දැන් බලන්න එනවා මේ මේ කියවලත් බලමු. එතකොට දැන් මේක එතකොට අපි නෝට් එකට ගිහිල්ලා කියවලා බලමු. එතකොට ඔයාට ලේසියෙන් මේ ගොළුට දා ගන්න පුළුවන්ද කියලා මේ බලන්න. මේ ෆස්ට් ප්‍රොපර්ටි මේ ප්‍රොපර්ටි සපෝර්ට් රිලේටඩ් ටු ෆන්ක්ෂන් කොහොමද කියන්නේ. අnder that මේ කියනවා attraction between water molecules due to hydrogen bonding is known as cohesion. තර මේක අන්ලයින් කරලා තියාගන්න. This is the definition of cohesion. හරිද? ඊට පස්සේ second attraction between water molecules and other substances are known as adhesion. දැන් example එකක් අපි xylem එකේ දැක්කා. Attraction between water molecules and the cell walls of xylem adhesion. Both of the above properties. One of the both of the above properties. So we can write write there high adhesion and cohesion. That's the first property. Mean high cohesion and adhesion. Cohesion and adhesion. Both of the above properties. That's the first property. Make a palani property. Make a palani property. High cohesion and adhesion. Both of the above properties can make. Both of the above properties, that means high cohesion and addition of water, allow it to act as a transport medium. Transport medium means the role මේක තමයි රෝල් එක. So what is the property? මේ බලන්න එකම ෆෝමැට් එක මේ කියන්නේ the property is high quotient and addition. Due to that property, what's the function or what's the role by water? Act as a transport medium. මේක තමයි මෙයාගේ රෝල් එක. Clear? Then to understand that we can consider this example. මේ බලන්න අපි කතා කරපු කතාව. Due to cohesion between water molecules, water and dissolved substances such as minerals are transported as a continuous column. මේ continuous column through xylem against the gravity. That means those cohesive and adhesive forces are enough to conduct water as a continuous column or to conduct water without separating molecules against the gravity. Gravity එකට against upward conduct කරන්න තරම් ඇති ඒවා. පැහැදිලි නේද? Addition between water molecules and cell walls also help in conduction of water and dissolved substances. So this is the example. ඔක තමයි example එක. හරිනේ ascent of xylem separate නැත්නම් upward conduction of water and minerals in xylem against the gravity, that is the example. අලමයි මට කියන්න දැන් did you get this clearly? මොන හරි ප්‍රශ්න තියෙනවා නම් අහන්න. Shihana නම් මේ why upper water molecules only up කියලා. Moves only up. Upper නෙමෙයි upper උඩට යනවා පහළ ඒවාත් එක්කත් එක්කම යනවා. Okay ඔයගලන්ට අර අපි ඉස්සරහට ඉගෙන ගන්නවා Shihana මේ plant transport වලදී ඔය මං කිව්වේ upper water molecules pull up කියලා. Due to an upward force. ඉස්සරහට ඉගෙන ගන්නවා ascent of xylem sap වලදී උමනා වෙන act කරන fact එකක් තියෙනවා transpiration pull කියලා. And when transpiration happens, it creates a pulling action on water within the xylem. Due to that, upper water molecules are pulled up. Transpiration pull the upper water molecules upward. Then together with those upper water molecules, lower water molecules also attracted as a continuous column due to this high adhesion and cohesion. Hari there. පටියට තේරුණාද? හරි වගේ නේද? ප්‍රශ්නයක් නැහැ වගේ. එහෙනම් අපි ඊළඟට යමු. නොතිරුණ තහඬ. මොකද නැහැ මේකනේ. නැහැ. good questions නැහැ. හරි අහන්න එන ඊට පස්සේ second property. Second sub property due to second sub property under cohesive behavior. Second sub property under cohesive behavior. Methane. High surface tension of water. Second sub-property, water has high surface tension. Water has high surface tension. Clear? What is the first we can understand simply? What is the surface tension? Mukhata surface tension kila balan. Surface tension means simply then hitanda me imagine this is a water layer. This is the surface of the water column. ඉතන මේ තියෙන water column එකේ surface. These are the surface water molecules. මේ A මේ තියෙන මේ these are surface water molecules. Water molecules at surface කියලා label කරලා තියෙනවා. And imagine these arrows represent hydrogen bonds. හරිනේ? දැන් බලන්න මෙහෙම what is the surface tension forces? Surface tension forces means simply මේ attraction forces between water molecules at the surface. හොඳට බලන්න. This attraction forces between water molecules at the surface are called surface tension forces. What are these actually? මොනවද ඇත්තටම මේ? මේ attraction forces between these water molecules at the surface are known as surface tension forces. These are simply cohesive forces. Attraction between these water molecules cohesive forces. In other words, they are hydrogen bonds. ඒවා hydrogen bonds. පැහැදිලි නේද? මේ specifically කියනවා attraction forces between water molecules at the surface, that means the cohesive forces or hydrogen bonds found between the water molecules at the surface are known as surface tension forces. To make a surface tension can be attraction force is somewhat like a tension. Make a tension force. Attraction force. Attraction forces or tension forces between the water molecules at the surface known as surface tension forces. We are going to surface tension forces. We said that hydrogen bonds are comparatively strong compared to other weak intermolecular interactions. Comparatively strong. Therefore, we can say Then means surface tension forces means hydrogen bonds. Therefore, we can say these surface tension forces are comparatively strong. Water has high surface tension forces. Water has high surface tension forces. Due to these high surface tension forces, we can say water molecules at the surface are attracted to each other like this. Due to high surface tension forces, water molecules at the surface are attracted to each other like this. And also, water molecules at the surface are attracted to low water molecules as well. Due to high cohesion or due to high surface tension, water molecules at the surface are attracted to each other strongly. Similarly, water molecules at the surface are attracted to low water molecules. Pahala water molecules are attracted. So due to this attraction of water molecules to each other, water molecules at the surface, water molecules near the surface, arrange as a continuous film. Water molecules due to high surface tension, water molecules at the surface are attracted to each other. Meanwhile, water molecules at the surface are attracted to lower water molecules of a pond. Then, due to this attraction between water molecules at the surface and as well as in the low water molecules, water molecules arrange as a film near the surface. Film ekak wage arrange wenawa. Thin film ekak wage. Eke mean wenne mokakda? Wen widere kiyoth water molecules arrange as a film means, in other words, water molecules at the surface are not easily separated from each other. Leesi ekinekin aath wenna naha kiyana ekai me kiyanne. Eken hari nikan ekinekata bandichcha molecules thiyena film ekak wage, continuous film ekak wage me wade. පැහැදිලි මෙයා කි ලේසින් සෙපරේට් වෙන්නේ නැහැ කියන එකයි. පැහැදිලිද කියන එක? අතර ඔළුවට දාගෙන නම් due to high surface tension what happens? Upper surface water molecules are attracted to each other and also upper surface water molecules are attracted to lower water molecules. Therefore water arranges as a continuous film at the surface. So due to that what happens? Since water molecules arrange as a continuous film or since they are not easily separated from each other, small waves and small insects like these water skaters, these are water skaters. Small insects like water skaters can easily walk on a pond. Clear? That means surface of water provide habitat for these small insects. Or body insects that are water is yanda puluwa, walk karanna puluwa. Small insects like water skaters can move on surface of a pond. In other words, they do not sink. Gilenne ne. Roka aige tani patta hitanne. If surface tension forces of water are weak, if surface tension of water are weak, then what? Surface tension weak. If surface tension forces of water becomes weak, then what? Then these water molecules will be easily separated from each other. Tagala separated. Then water molecules will be easily separated from each other. Then surface water molecules can't bear a weight on top of it. Means surface water molecules can't bear a weight. Then when in such a case, when small insects like water skaters start to move on the surface of water, then what happens? Water molecules will be easily separated from each other. Then insect will sink inside water. Clear? So without sinking, water skaters can walk on the surface of a pond. Why? Water molecules at the surface are attracted to each other strongly and they arrange as a continuous film. Did you get this? පැහැදිලිද කතාව? දැන් ඔබ තව ටිකක් හොඳට තේරුම් අරගෙන තව ටිකක් නිකන් ඔයගොල්ලෝ දැකලා තියෙන එකක් ටික තව හිතන්න පුළුවන්. You can think with your experience. Here I think you have seen that me. This is some water leak from a tap. They leak as droplets. Here. And also I think you have seen this phenomenon as well at the tip of the leaves. Water arranges as droplets like this. Or on the leaves sometimes these kind of water droplets are present. How? Why water arrange like this as droplets without evenly spread on the surface? Without spreading on the surface, why this small amount of water can arrange as droplets? I am a droplet with an arranging. It's like this. Here, imagine this is the enlarged view of this water droplet. These are the surface water molecules. These surface water molecules are attracted to each other due to their high surface tension. And also surface water molecules are attracted to lower or inner water molecules due to their high surface tension. Therefore, these water molecules at the surface of the droplet are attracted to each other strongly due to high surface tension or due to high cohesive forces. Clear? So it's somewhat, it is also somewhat like arranging as an outer film. Then these outer water molecules attracted to each other can retain inner amount of water. Clear? Matha hari nika bag ekak athule tikak film ekak athule water tikak dala thiyena wage. Inner water will not remove out or will not escape from this droplet. Due to high surface tension, outer surface water molecules attracted to each other strongly, then they can retain some amount of water inside. So water arranges as droplets. Droplets they arrange. If surface tension of water is very weak, then may water molecules at the surface of droplet are not strongly attracted. Then they can retain, they can maintain inner amount of water like this. Then water molecules will be spread. If the surface tension is high, they can arrange as droplets like this. Mercury, well, have you seen this in mercury? Mercury, in physics also you will learn. You have calculations in physics regarding the surface tension. Physics will learn part of it. There's a separate unit called properties of matter. Under that, you will learn surface tension. There are calculations as well. There you can see. Learn some calculations as well. There you will learn mercury has very high surface tension. Have you seen what happened to mercury when you pour some mercury on the wall on a substrate? Then if we pour large amount of water on a surface, they will not arrange as droplets and they will spread even. But if you put some mercury on a substrate, if you pour some mercury onto a substrate, what happened? They will not spread even, mostly. Then what happened? Mercury can arrange as droplets or globules like this. You have to globules will arrange due to their high surface tension. Then start to flow. Move in the water. Like a loku, I can water will have high surface tension and good arc, mercury. Try to make a globules will arrange it. හරිනේද දැන් මට කියන්න තේරෙනවද කියලා කතාව අපි කියවලත් බලමු ඊට පස්සේ further clarification මොනවද තිබ්බොත් අහන්න මේ දින් it says water බලන්න you know water has high surface tension underline this is the second major sub property under water underline කරලා තියන්න this is the second major sub property ඒක explain කරලා කියනවා this ability is given to water molecules due to cohesion හරිනේ කියන්නේ hydrogen bonds This ability is given to water molecules due to cohesion between water molecules. Between the water molecules. That is the property. Now this is the role. Therefore, in an aquatic system, upper surface water molecules are attracted by lower surface water molecules. And it forms a water film. And then that's a role. Due to high surface tension, water molecules at the surface arrange as a continuous film. Then example, there are four small insects. Example, water skaters can walk on the surface of a pond. Clear the balanda? Monohari prashna tipana handa. Okay. Good question, Nanny. I didn't know them. I'm good. I'm good. Response I'm not my own property. Next major property. Ability to moderate temperature. Next major property, ability to moderate temperature. Under this major property, again, we are discussing two subproperties. There are two subproperties. Among those, here this is the first. First subproperty under this is water has high specific heat capacity. High specific heat capacity. Now recall from your O-levels, What is specific heat capacity? What is specific heat capacity? What is specific heat capacity? Recall from your O-level knowledge. O-level knowledge, you can recall what is specific heat capacity? What is specific heat capacity? Then imagine this, there is a substance here. 1 kilogram of substance, if we supply heat, we get heat supply to it. If we supply heat, what happens? Its temperature increases. When we supply heat, its temperature increases. Amen. The specific heat capacity, the specific heat capacity means amount of heat that is required to increase the temperature of 1 kilogram of substance by 1 degree of Celsius or by 1 Kelvin. Amount of heat that is required to increase the temperature of 1 kilogram of substance by 1 degree of Celsius or by 1 Kelvin. That is known as specific heat capacity. Every substance has specific heat capacity. The significance of water is, this is comparatively higher value. Let's say this is water. If this is water, the specific heat capacity is very high. That's the significance. If this is water, the specific heat capacity is very high. That's the significance. Clear? That means having high specific heat capacity means comparatively high amount of heat should be supplied to increase the temperature of water by 1 degree Celsius. That's the idea. Comparatively high amount of heat should be supplied to increase the temperature of water by 1 degree Celsius. That's the idea. That means even though very high amount of heat, very high amount of heat should be supplied to increase the temperature of water by 1 degree Celsius. That's the idea. That means even though we supply very high amount of heat, temperature increase of water is less. Even though we supply very high amount of heat, temperature increase of water is very slight, less. Why absorption pattern? Anipatri that. If heat is dissipated from this, again heat dissipated not one. If heat is dissipated or lost from water, then what happens? Temperature decreases. Temperature decreases. So due to high specific heat capacity thing, we said that very high amount of heat should be supplied to increase the temperature of water by 1 degree Celsius. Mean likewise, to decrease the temperature of 1 degree Celsius, we can say very high amount of heat should be lost from water. Clear? Due to high specific heat capacity, to decrease the temperature of water by 1 degree Celsius, very high amount of heat should be lost from water. Even though very high amount of heat is lost from water, temperature decrease of water is very less. Due to high specific heat capacity, water can absorb or release high amount of heat energy with a slight change in its own temperature. Due to high specific heat capacity, water can absorb or release very high amount of heat energy with a slight change in its own temperature. That means even though very high amount of heat is absorbed or released, temperature change of water is very slight. Water will change, temperature change meaning very slight. Therefore, due to this property, it is said water acts as a thermal buffer. Due to this feature, water acts as a thermal buffer in living systems and aquatic bodies during temperature fluctuations on Earth. What's the meaning of buffer? Thermal buffer. Then in chemistry, you will learn about pH buffers. pH buffers means a solution which can maintain constant pH is a pH buffer. Solution which can maintain constant pH can be considered as a pH buffer. Okay. Likewise, thermal buffer means a solution which can maintain constant temperature. So water is a good buffer. Why? Even the very high amount of heat is absorbed, its temperature increases slightly. Even the very high amount of heat is lost, its temperature decreases slightly due to its high specific heat levels. So water resists to change its temperature. So it acts as a thermal buffer in living systems and aquatic bodies. That means within the organism's body, huge amount of heat is generated. Then in our human body, during metabolic reactions, very high amount of heat is produced. Okay? But the major component of our body is water. Out of the total body weight, around 70% is water. Okay? Therefore, even though very high amount of heat is produced, our temperature increase is slight. Okay? So therefore, this is important to maintain constant body temperature of homeotherms as well. What are these homeotherms? This is important to maintain constant body temperature homeotherms. Homeotherms means warm-blooded animals. Warm-blooded animals, you know, they can maintain constant body temperature. Okay? And we are homeotherms. We are warm-blooded. So since the main component of our body is water, even though very high amount of heat is produced inside our body, temperature increase inside the body is less. Similarly, even the very high amount of heat is lost from our body, temperature drop is less due to the significant property of water. Therefore, this high specific heat capacity is important to maintain constant body temperature warm-blooded animals as well. Remember, due to this high specific heat capacity, water functions as a thermal buffer in living systems. And aquatic bodies, during temperature fluctuations on Earth, aquatic bodies will make important. Now, we make example of the slide. Look at this. Make a balance of it. And I think you have experienced this in life. If you consider, if you move to seashore or near a river or reservoir, you have experienced this. Let's say here this is sand. This is water. During daytime, both water and sand absorb heat. When slight amount of heat is absorbed, temperature of sand increases drastically. Why? Sand has very low specific heat capacity. Even when slight amount of heat is absorbed, its temperature increases drastically. Tagal increases. But water, even though very high amount of heat is absorbed by water, its temperature increase is slight due to its high specific heat capacity. So it can maintain constant temperature inside water. That's a thermal buffering function. එක තමයි thermal buffer එකක්. ඒ කියන්නේ දැන් අපි තමු දැන් රස්ති වුණාට පස්සේ සීෂෝ එකේ. හරි මතන් ගඟක් මුදක් ගාව. ගඟක් ගාව වැවක් ගාව මොකද අපි කරන්නේ? Sand රස්නි. ටක් ගලපු වතුරට බයි. වතුර සීතල. So this is important. එකයි කියන්නේ water functions as a thermal buffer in living systems like this. Living systems and aquatic bodies like this. During the temperature fluctuations on Earth. Clear? So this is important for the survival of these kind of aquatic organisms. Here, this fish says, I love specific heat capacity of water. Why? Then think in the opposite way. If specific heat capacity of water is very low, what happened? It will behave like sand. When little amount of heat is absorbed, its temperature increases drastically. Then these water bodies will be quickly become hot. Then these aquatic organisms can't live. Clear? Pahadirudu kiyana eka. Karaneda lamme. Dan balamu nan api owara mona hari prashna thibbot ahanda. Note ekak kiyala balanda eka. Onna. This is the first property under ability to moderate temperature. On underline kala thiyaganna water has high specific heat capacity. Water has high specific heat capacity. Then it is described. Amethan api lila thiyagamu amathak katirath ekka write what is write the meaning of specific heat capacity. Write there. Amethan liyanda specific heat capacity means right? There are specific heat capacity means. Specific heat capacity means the amount of heat required, the amount of heat required the amount of heat required to increase the temperature of 1 kilogram of substance, to increase the temperature of 1 kilogram of substance, to increase the temperature of 1 kilogram of substance, increase the temperature of 1 kilogram of substance by 1 degree of Celsius, by 1 degree of Celsius, or else you can say by 1 Kelvin, by 1 degree of Celsius, all right, by 1 Kelvin. හරිනේද? අතර දැන් ඕක පාඩම් කරනකොට ඔකත් එක බලමු තේරෙනවා. දැන් අතර මේ ඔය ප්‍රොපර්ටි එක එහෙම නැත්නම් the amount of heat required is very high කියන එකයි කියන්නේ. High specific heat capacity. Therefore this is the rule me. Therefore water can absorb or release a relatively high amount of heat energy by a slight change in its own temperature. ඒක තමයි අපි අර ඉස්සෙල්ලා කිව්වේ. That's what we said. Even though water absorbs very high amount of heat, or even though very high amount of heat is released from water, temperature fluctuation is minimal. Therefore, due to high specific heat, water will function as a thermal buffer in living systems and aquatic bodies during the temperature fluctuations on Earth. Kiyanne. Api ilan anitha karun denna liyala danna. Metana liyanna. This is also important right here. This is also important. Right here, this is also important. This is also important to maintain constant body temperature. This is also important to maintain constant body temperature This is also important to maintain constant body temperature in homeotherms, here homeotherms within brackets warm blooded animals, homeotherms within brackets warm blooded animals, හරිනේ. Okay, that's about the specific high specific heat capacity. ඊගොඩ බලන්න. Next property. Next property is high heat of vaporization. Next property under ability to moderate temperature, water has high heat of vaporization. And water has high heat of vaporization. So what is this heat of vaporization? මොකද ළමයි මේ heat of vaporization කියලා කියන්නේ? හරියට මෙන්න මේ වගේ. Look at this. Heat of vaporization refers to the amount of heat required. අපි තුමු දැන් මෙතනදී අපි heat supply කරා. We supply heat. මෙතන නම් මේ latent heat කියලා දෙන්නේ. Latent heat is the amount of heat that is required to convert liquid water at 100 degrees of Celsius to its gaseous state. මේ 100 degrees වලදී ඕන එක තමයි latent heat කියලා කියන්නේ. But here we are not discussing about the latent heat here. අපි discuss කරන්නේ latent heat එක නෙමෙයි. දැන් මේ diagram එකේ නම් තියෙන latent heat ගැන. But we are discussing about evaporation of water here even at low temperatures, not only at 100 degrees of Celsius. Latent heat applied for 100 degrees of Celsius at the boiling point. මේ කතා කරන්නේ generally even at low temperatures. බලන්න හැබැයි මේ කතාව තමයි වෙන්නේ. බලන්න. Imagine these are the water molecules at the liquid state. This is the gaseous state. At your right hand side, gaseous state. Here, heat of vaporization means amount of heat that should be supplied. Let's say we are supplying heat. Up heat supply cannot be done. Let's say we supply heat like this. Heat supply. Let's say we are supplying heat. Heat of vaporization means amount of heat that is required to convert liquid into its gaseous state. Amount of heat that is required to convert a liquid of a substance to its gaseous state. Heat of vaporization. The amount of heat that should be required, that is required, the amount of heat that should be supplied to convert liquid into a gaseous state. That is heat of vaporization. The significance of water is, this heat of vaporization is comparatively high value. Make a value. Clear? That means, again, what the meaning? That means very high amount of heat. That means very high amount of heat should be supplied. Very high amount of heat should be supplied to convert liquid water into its gaseous state. Gaseous state ekata convert karanna loku heat ekak denna one. High amount of heat should be supplied to convert liquid water into its gaseous state. That's the idea. Therefore, we can say water has high heat of vaporization. Now think and tell me. Nikam poddak hitala kiyanda. Why this poddak hitanna den? Why this heat of vaporization of water is comparatively high? Why very high amount of heat is required to convert liquid water into its gaseous state? Ai ochchara heat ekak mokotada? Meme hitanne. What is the use of that heat when converting liquid water into its gaseous state? What is the use of that heat? For which purpose that heat is used? For supply can heat mokada the use? Manghani, simply why heat of vaporization is higher in water? And Aditya mentioned the answer. Others? Mukurada. What is the usage of that heat supplied in evaporating liquid water into gaseous state? Yes. To break down, then make your mahindutra again, to break down hydrogen bonds. To break down hydrogen bonds. Look at this. So if you consider this liquid water, you know, in between liquid water molecules here, there are hydrogen bonds. They are comparatively strong compared to other weak intermolecular interactions. But if you consider gaseous state of water, in gaseous state, water molecules are found more apart to each other. Then in the gaseous state, hydrogen bonds do not exist in between water molecules. Or even though they are present, they are very weak. Again, hydrogen bonds are not present between this water vapor between water molecules at the gaseous state. There are no hydrogen bonds. That means what happened here, when liquid water converts into its gaseous state, hydrogen bonds are broken. Hydrogen bonds are broken down. So this heat that we supply, is actually used to break down these hydrogen bonds. Clear? Then since these hydrogen bonds are comparatively stronger, more heat is required to break down bonds, to break down hydrogen bonds. That means it's like this. To break down a bond, heat should be supplied. When heat is supplied, bonds will be broken. If the bond is stronger, more heat is required to break down the bond. Yeah, that's what happened here. Since hydrogen bonds are comparatively strong, very high amount of heat is required to break down the hydrogen bonds. Now you get the reason. So here also, you can see these properties also related to hydrogen bond. Now you can understand water has high heat of vaporization. Clear? Water has high heat of vaporization. Then this is important. This having high heat of vaporization is actually important to cool down the body surface of organisms. In other words, this is important to cool down the body surface of organisms through evaporative cooling. As an example, we can consider secretion of sweat onto our skin surface in hot climate. We know in hot climates, or when our body temperature is higher than normal, the sweat glands in the skin are stimulated and secrete more sweat onto our skin surface. So this sweating helps to cool down the body surface. How it happens? Then sweat, main component of sweat is water. Main component of sweat is water. Okay. Then what happened here? In hot conditions, so when the body temperature is higher than normal, more sweat is secreted. Onto the body surface. Then to evaporate water in this sweat, very high amount of heat should be absorbed from the body surface. Why? More heat should be absorbed from the skin surface or from the body surface to evaporate water in the sweat. Water has high heat of vaporization. Clear? Therefore, to evaporate water in the sweat, more heat should be absorbed from the body surface. Clear? When more heat is absorbed from the body surface, very little amount of water will be evaporated. Therefore, what happens here? Water in sweat absorb very high amount of heat and evaporate. Clear? Since very high amount of heat should be absorbed from the body surface, body surface will be cooled down. Loku heat ekak absorb kara water evaporated. Etukota body surface ekak cool down. Clear? So due to high specific heat capacity, even though very high amount of heat is absorbed from the body, very little amount of water will be evaporated. This is important. Due to high heat of vaporization, organisms can release much heat energy like this. With a minimum loss of water from their body. Organisms can release much heat energy. Here, very little amount of water in sweat will be evaporated by absorbing high amount of heat. Then, by losing little amount of water from the body, body surface can be quickly cooled down. That's the importance. Due to high heat of vaporization, what happens? Organisms can release much heat energy like this with a minimum loss of water from their body surface. Example, sweating in human skin. Cool down the body surface through evaporative cooling. Clear? Then if you didn't understand that, think the opposite way. Think in the opposite way, then you can easily understand. If heat of vaporization of water is very low, what happens? Then water in sweat will be quickly evaporated by absorbing little amount of heat. Even though little amount of heat is absorbed, very large amount of heat, water will be quickly evaporated. So loku water amount ekak evaporated. But the amount of heat absorbed will be less. Clear? If water has low heat of vaporization, very low heat of vaporization, huge amount of water will be lost from the body by absorbing little amount of heat. Poddak heat absorb karapu taggala water ki operate. Hari thoda loku water amount ekak operate no heat poddak absorb. Then to cool down the body surface, very huge amount of water should be lost from the body. Then person will be dehydrated. හරිද? But එතකොට හිතන්න due to high specific high heat of vaporization with the minimum loss of water, very much high amount of heat can be dissipated from the body. පැහැදිලිද? Same thing can be applied to plants. Plants also do the same. Plant වලත් මේකම වෙනවා. In transpiration බලන්න transpiration වලදී ඕකම නෙවෙයි. During transpiration මේ water inside the leaf cells evaporated like this. මේ water inside the leaf cells evaporated. ඒකෙත් වෙන්නේ liquid water inside the leaf principal cells get evaporated. Clear? Therefore to convert liquid water into water vapor in transpiration plant mata water in the leaf cells absorb heat from the plant body surface. Therefore plant body surface will be quickly cooled down. So this is transpiration in plants helps to cool down the body surface of plant. And even though outer environment is too hot. දැන් බලන්න එකින් අපි කියනවා මෙතන මේ බලන්න අපි ඔක දැන් අතර ෆන්ක්ෂන් එකත් එක්ක රිලේට් කරලා කිව්වොත් මේ බලන්න මේ due to high heat of vaporization with the minimum loss of water an organism can release much heat energy therefore body surface of an organism maintain as a cool surface කියලා කියනවා so this is the role එක තමයි role examples දෙනවා මෙන්න මේ දෙක consider කරන්න පුළුවන් as examples we can consider sweating and transpiration in plants then කියමු note එක Even maybe second property due to high heat of vaporization. Means due to high heat of vaporization, with the minimum loss of water, an organism can release much heat energy. So remember the function. Remember the role. Underline කරලා දියාගන්න. This helps the organism to cool their body surface. කියලා කියන. That is the importance of having high heat of vaporization. With the minimum loss of water, an organism can release much heat energy. This helps organisms to cool their body surface. The main examples. This prevents from overheating. It prevents overheating of the body. Body ko overheat wenne ne. More heat can be quickly dissipated with the loss of minimum amount of water. Karne. Then second example, evaporation of sweat from the human skin helps to maintain body temperature at constant level. Now we found that two properties contribute in maintaining constant body temperature. Here this is high heat of vaporization. Previous one. High specific heat capacity. Similarly, transpiration in plants helps to cool down the plant body surface and prevent from becoming too warm in sunlight. That's about the second major property. ඔයාලන්ට මේ අමතක නම් high heat of vaporization මේ කියන heat of vaporization කියන්නේ මොකක්ද කියලා site එකේ note එකක් දාලා තියාගන්න නිකන්. පාඩම් කරනකොට පස්සේ මතක් ඔක ගලප ගන්න පුළුවන්. ලියලා තියාගන්න එතනින් heat of vaporization කියන්නේ මොකක්ද කියලා. Right there. Right there heat of vaporization means ලියන්න heat of vaporization means heat of vaporization means the amount of heat required the amount of heat required The amount of heat required to convert liquid of a substance to convert liquid of a substance to its gaseous state to convert liquid of a substance to its gaseous state to convert liquid of a substance to its gaseous state. රෝග ගොඩක් වැඩි වැලිව එකක් කියන එකයි ඔබ කියන්නේ. හරි නේද? Now we will go to the next property. Next major property is expansion upon freezing. Expansion upon freezing. හරි. For this moment, forget about water. Water අමතක කරන්න. Forget about water. Then think about other substances. Water අමතක කරලා අනිත් substances ගැන හිතන්න. මේ other substances behave like this. අනිත් substances behave වෙන්නේ මෙන්න මේ වගේ. මේ බලන්න හොඳට. This is other substance. මේ තියෙන අනිත් substances ගැන. මෙන්න මෙතන තියෙන්නේ මේ. මෙන්න මේ කතාව වලට දාගන්න. Other substance. Let's say here on other thing එක. බලන්න this is a solid. මේ තියෙන මෙයාගේ solid එක. This is a solid of a substance. So it, let's say it has a constant mass. අපිට mass එක m. M mass එකක් තියෙනවා. M එකක් හරි gram. Mass එක same. Then this solid, හොඳට බලන්න solid converts to its liquid. Solid එක යාගේ liquid එකට convert කරනවා. මේ බලන්න solid is converted to its liquid. Solid එක යාගේ liquid එකට convert කරනවා. This is the liquid of the same substance. මේ තියෙන මෙයාගේ liquid එක. Let's say the mass is same. මේකෙත් mass එක එකමයි m gram. දැන් බලන්න what happened to මේ බලන්න what happened to the density when solid, this is not about water, think about any other substance. Any substance again hitanda, other substances behave like this. When solid of that substance convert to its liquid, what happened to the density? Density ekata mokakda? Then definitely you know solid has a higher density than the liquid, so therefore density decreases. Density decreases, correct? When solid converts into a liquid, density decreases. Density decreases now. Volume, volume increases. If mass is constant, you know this relationship. Density equals mass over volume. If mass is constant, when density decreases, volume should increase. Then opposite happens. Okay, when a liquid converts into a solid, when liquid converts to a solid, liquid එකක් solid වෙනකොට its density increases, volume decreases. එහෙමනේ අපිට ඕක දැන් මෙතන represent කරලා ඇඳලා පෙන්නන්න පුළුවන්. ඔක උතන අපි කොහොමද draw කරලා තියාගන්නේ. මෙහෙම let's say this is m mass of a substance. This is other substance. මේ අපි කතා කරන්නේ other substance එකක් නේ, not about water. Let's say this is in liquid state. මේ තියෙන මේ liquid state. So what here molecules are, let's say molecules are arranged like this. Imagine these are the molecules found in the liquid state. මේ තියෙන this is the arrangement of molecules in the liquid state. So in liquid state, you know molecules are arranged more apart to each other compared to solid. That means intermolecular distance is higher. Intermolecular distance එක වැඩි. හරිද? Then අපි දමු we dissipate heat. මේක heat loss වෙනවා. නැත්නම් temperature decreases. Temperature decreases. Temperature decreases. That means freezing of this happen. මේක freeze වෙනවා. එතකොට මොකද වෙන්නේ? Liquid converts into a solid. Liquid එක convert වෙනවා solid එකට. Mass is same. මේකේ mass එක m gram. Let's say mass remain constant, make it m gram. Then liquid convert into a solid, make it a solid substance of the same. Mass same m gram. What happened? When liquid converts to a solid, density increases. Density increases. Density increases. When density increases, volume decreases. Density increases and volume decreases. Why actually? I am going at it. Because when liquid convert into a solid, these molecules may arrange more closer to each other. Molecules are tightly packed. Molecules of a substance may closely arrange or tightly packed like this. Tightly packed. Molecules tightly packed. Tightly packed. That means the intermolecular distance become lesser. Molecules tightly packed and intermolecular distance become lesser. Then volume decreases, volume compresses, then density increases. Density means volume in a unit, density means mass in a unit volume. When volume decreases, then volume compresses. mass in a unit volume is height density increases. So this is the behavior of any other substance. Clear? When liquid converts into a solid, density increases, volume decreases. The other way, when solid converts into a liquid, due to increasing of temperature, density decreases, volume increases. That is the behavior of other substances, not about water. Mulling up in Nepaludaga. Then make you wonder. Generally, in an increase in temperature of any substances, not water specifically, any substances, reduces their density. And on the other hand, in decreasing temperature, in a decreasing temperature, increases their density. The volume decreases. Now to show that within this space, shall we draw this diagram? When during freezing, when liquid converts into a solid, density increases, volume decreases. To show that, draw this. Remember, it happens because compared to a liquid, when it converts into a solid, molecules are tightly packed. Intermolecular distance become lesser. That's why. Then volume decreases. Then definitely density increases. Now we will think about water. Then balanda water. Water has an abnormal behavior. This is the behavior of other substance in freezing. But water has unusual behavior. Water has unusual behavior. What happens to water? This is about water. Water has unusual behavior. It's like this actually. I will show you a graph. So this represents the changing of the density of water against temperature. Okay. We are considering about the freezing. That means we are considering about decreasing of temperature. Okay, look at the graph. My graph ke diha balanda. Here you can see this is 0 degrees of Celsius. This is 11. That means we are reading the graph in this direction. May patre abhi main kiye bani, because we are discussing about freezing here. We need about freezing or solidification. So look at this. When temperature decreases like this, when temperature of water decreases, water also behave as other substance until 4 degrees of Celsius. Until 4 degrees of Celsius, water also behave as other substances. That means, like in other substance, when temperature decreases, in freezing, density of water also increases. May density increase. When temperature increases, density has increased. Then definitely volume should decrease. Clear? That means up to 4 degrees of Celsius, water also behave like that. Then unusual behavior of water begins when temperature decreases below 4 degrees of Celsius. When unusual behavior of water can be observed when temperature decreases below 4 degrees of Celsius. Clear? Then it says, water start to freeze. Water begins to freeze when its temperature decreases below 4 degrees of Celsius. Then in your O-levels, you have learned that water completely freezes at 0 degrees of Celsius. That is true. That means at 0 degrees of Celsius, ice can be observed. 0 degrees of the ice tamati. But remember, water begins to freeze. When its temperature decreases below 4 degrees of Celsius. When the main point again pass. Water begins to freeze when its temperature decreases below 4 degrees of Celsius. Now look at the way how water behaves. When temperature decreases below 4 degrees of Celsius, what has happened to its density? Density decreased. Then volume should increase. This is considered as the volume expansion. This is the expansion of volume in freezing. But it's completely abnormal. Other substances do not behave like this. When temperature decreases below 4 degrees of Celsius, water starts to freeze. Then volume increases, volume expands, density decreases. It is an unusual behavior of water. Clear? So why water behaves like this? In liquid state, imagine this is the liquid water, and these are the water molecules. Oxygen, hydrogen atoms are indicated. These are water molecules. Recall we said that in liquid state, imagine these are the hydrogen bonds. Let's say these dotted lines represent hydrogen bonds. So what can we say about hydrogen bonds of water at liquid state? In liquid state, the water molecules are closely held together by weak hydrogen bonds. At liquid state, what can we say about the nature of the hydrogen bonds? These hydrogen bonds are fragile. That means these hydrogen bonds are not stable. Clear? At liquid state, these hydrogen bonds are not stable or fragile. But these hydrogen bonds keep water molecules much closer to each other at the liquid state. Clear? But when the temperature decreases below 4 degrees of Celsius, what happens? This freezing begins. Then it starts to become solid. When temperature decreases below 4 degrees of Celsius, freezing begins and ice start to form. It forms ice cubes. Then during this, when temperature decreases below 4 degrees of Celsius, water freezes and form ice cubes are then then it is said water molecules arrange as a crystalline lattice meaning this is the lattice structure me penna neme lattice structure water molecules arrange as a crystalline lattice me andala din lattice structure මොන හොඳට ආයි පාරක් උඩට දාන්න මම සමරි එකක් කියනවා when the temperature of water decreases below 4 degrees celsius water start to freeze then water molecules arrange as a crystalline lattice like this clear then what happens then during this hydrogen bonds of water become stable මෙතන කියනවා on reaching solid state hydrogen bonds become stable arranging water molecules far apart from each other ඒ කියන්නේ බලන්න හොඳට ළමයි මොකද්ද වෙන්නේ When temperature decreases below 4 degrees of Celsius, water molecules start to arrange more apart to each other. And they will arrange as a crystalline lattice. Or the lattice structure. Clear? Then during this, the hydrogen bonds of water become stable. What will hydrogen bond stable with? When temperature decreases below 4 degrees of Celsius, hydrogen bonds of water become stable. Then water molecules arrange more apart to each other and arrange as a crystalline lattice. Then what happened to volume? When water molecules move apart to each other and arrange as a crystalline lattice, volume expands. That is why volume expands. So, I will have what volume expanded. When temperature decreases below 4 degrees of Celsius, hydrogen bonds become stable. And water molecules move apart to each other and arrange as a crystalline lattice. Then volume expands. Then density decreases. At the beginning, that's why volume expands when temperature decreases below 4 degrees of Celsius and density decreases. Therefore, I think you have observed this. Dakala din meka. Ogala maithan meka experience karala thati. If you put some ice cubes on water, what happened? If you put some ice cubes on water, they will not sink. Sink venne dakala divane. Ice floats on water. Why? Ice has higher volume and low density compared to liquid water. Therefore, ice floats on water. But if you put a solid of any other substance into its liquid, what happens? If you put some iron balls in liquid iron, you put some iron balls in liquid iron, what will happen? Instantly, it will sink. Taggara sink. Then it will dissolve due to high temperature, but it will sink. Sink. Water has unusual behavior mainly when the temperature decreases below 4 degrees of Celsius. Then volume expands, density decreases. Therefore, the biological important thing is due to this, ice will float on the surface of water bodies. Make the ice float on water bodies on the surface. Biologically important. Make a total experience. Then when you completely fill a glass bottle with water, with the water is completely filled into a glass bottle and tightly close the lid. Lid take tightly close that. Then if you keep this water bottle, glass water bottle inside freezer of your refrigerator. Deep freezer ke deep bottle mokada wenne. When liquid water converts into ice, what happens to the glass bottle? My glass bottle will rupture. Why? When liquid water converts to ice, when temperature decreases below 4 degrees of Celsius, its volume expands. පැහැදිලිද ළමයි? ඔතම කතාව. හරිනේ දැන් බලන්න ඔන්නෝග මෙතන explain කරලා තියෙනවා. මේ තියෙන. මෙතන කියන එකකින්ද මේ බලන්න මේ. When the temperature of water falls below 4 degrees of Celsius, it begins to freeze and forms a crystalline lattice called ice cubes. Ice cubes are Then on the line, write like this. Lines the gillian. When temperature decreases below 4 degrees of Celsius, below 4 degrees of Celsius, hydrogen bonds of water become stable. Hydrogen bonds of water become stable. Hydrogen bonds of water become stable. and water molecules arrange apart to each other. And water molecules arrange, move apart to each other. And water molecules arrange, move apart to each other. Water molecules arrange, move apart to each other. As a crystalline lattice. As a crystalline lattice. As a crystalline lattice. Then volume expands. Then volume expands. Then volume expands. And density decreases. Volume expands and density decreases. Therefore, water has the maximum density at 4 degrees of Celsius. Water has the maximum density at 4 degrees of Celsius. Hence, ice floats on the surface of water bodies. Make it important. Underline this is the role due to this property. Expansion upon freezing is the property. Due to that, the biologically important role is ice floats on the surface of water bodies. Make example this is an important property of water in polar regions, specifically in polar regions where organisms in aquatic bodies can survive during winter. That means, in other words, since ice floats on surface of water bodies, aquatic organisms in polar regions can survive inside water during winter. Clear? And here, then these are the, this can be observed in polar regions, and you know in polar regions it has seasonal variation. This is summer, may fall, spring, winter. In winter season, we can see ice on the surface of water body. Then at the bottom, we can see liquid water. A liquid water can be observed. Likewise, may ice floats on the surface of water body and keep liquid water at the bottom. Clear? This is due to expansion upon freezing. Then think in the opposite. Anipatri. Think in the opposite. Then I mean, if ice has higher density than liquid water, or if water also behave like other substances, then ice will have higher density than liquid water. Then what? The ice form, then during winter, outer temperature becomes minus degrees of Celsius, or very low. Then from the surface of the water body, therefore heat will be dissipated. Heat loss will. Therefore, ice will form at the surface of the water. If ice has higher density than liquid water, what happens? These ice forms will settle at the bottom like this. That means ice form will settle at the bottom of the water body. Clear? So if such a thing happens, within few days, entire water body will be completely freeze like this. Then aquatic organisms can't live. Clear? If ice also has higher density than liquid water, ice form at the surface will easily sink at the bottom. Clear? Exposing liquid water to the surface. Again, ice form will sink at the bottom. Likewise, entire water body will be quickly freeze. But it never happens due to this property. How? Ice form here floats on the surface of water. Keeping liquid water at the bottom, or liquid water range. Right? Then in the liquid phase, in the liquid region, actually water arrange as layers depending on their density. Mean here, just below the ice layer, it has water at 0 degrees of Celsius. You know, at 0 degrees of Celsius, it has low density. Likewise, mean below that, it has water at 2 degrees of Celsius. Then towards the bottom, mean it has water at the water with the highest density. Water has the highest density at 4 degrees of Celsius. Clear? Therefore, Nibalanda, when water arrangement, liquid water arranged like this according to the density, at the bottom of the water body, 4 degrees of Celsius will be maintained. So this is too much enough for the aquatic organisms to survive during winter. Clear? That is the importance. Clear? Neither? Did you all get this? So here, we will draw then the Baluhama Taggala paint. We will draw the volume expansion. Our volume expansion is going to make a change. Draw the volume expansion. Now imagine this is then liquid water. So imagine this is, let's say this is liquid water. Then me water again. This is about water. This is liquid water. Let's say it has m mass. Then let's say here temperature decreases below 4 degrees of Celsius. Below 4 degrees of Celsius. Then what happens? Then water starts to freeze and arrange as a crystalline lattice. Then when water arranges as a crystalline lattice, volume should expand on a volumetric expand rate. Because my water molecules arrange more apart to each other, hydrogen bonds become stable, and water molecules arrange more apart to each other. Water molecules arrange more apart to each other. Adding arrangement. Water molecules will arrange more apart to each other like this. Water molecules will arrange more apart to each other. Adding arrangement like this. Then imagine these are the hydrogen bonds. Within hydrogen bonds, they become stable. Here, these are comparatively stable hydrogen bonds. This is the crystalline lattice. Oh, this is solid ice within ice cubes. So within parallel, don't know maybe the density during this density decreases, volume increases. කියන්නේ අර graph එකක් පහලින් මෙතන ඇදලා තියන්න. Then you can easily understand. මෙතන නිකන් sketch එකක් දාලා තියාගත්තා නම් හරි, here below this description you can draw the graph. I will show you. Graph එක නිකන් ඇදලා තියාගන්න. පොඩ ගාලා set වෙනවා. මෙන්න මේක. Sorry, this one. No need to put these exact values. මේ exact values ඕනේ. Just mention the density on y-axis. X-axis is temperature. Here this is 11 or something. This is 0. Draw the graph like this. At 4 degrees of Celsius, you can show highest density is present. 4 degrees of Celsius. Just draw the shape of the graph. At 4 degrees, it should have the highest density. No need to put all these values. Tag gala nin balanda. හරි නේද? දැන් ඔන්න properties තුනක් ඉවරයි. Then last property. Last major property. මේක ලේසි. Sorry. බලන්න. Last property. Versatility as a solvent. Versatility as a solvent. Then I think you are family with the word solute and solvent. Solute and solvent. Here it says water act as a good solvent. Clear? For four different type of solutes. You know, solute is a substance that dissolve in a solvent. So why then how why solute dissolve in a particular solvent? So when solute dissolve in a solvent, when solute dissolve in a solvent, O to dissolve solute in a solvent. Solute. But to dissolve solute in a solvent, remember to dissolve solute in a solvent, interactions should be formed between the solute and solvent. That means solute molecules should make interactions with the solvent molecules. Clear? Normally what happens in dissolving a solute in solvent, solute make interactions with solvent and solvent molecules surround the solute. Solute take a surround current. That's what should happen. Then think, then if you put some oil into water, you know oil and water do not dissolve. They separate as two layers. Oil and water separate as two layers. Layers they got separated. Hey, oil and water separate as two layers. Why? Because oil is non-polar. Water is polar. These nonpolar molecules can't make interactions with polar water. Nonpolar molecules can't make interactions with polar water. Therefore, nonpolar solute, nonpolar oil will separate as a layer. It will not make interactions with water. Clear? That means to dissolve, definitely solute should make interactions with polar. Then since this water is polar, it becomes a solvent for different other polar molecules. So if you put polar molecules into water, then what happens? Then polar molecules will make interactions with water. And then water molecules will surround the polar solid. Imagine this is glucose. Sugar crystal, glucose. Then how glucose dissolves in water? Like this. Then when glucose dissolves in water, glucose is a polar molecule. When glucose dissolves in water, glucose molecules make interactions with these water molecules. And each glucose molecule or the solute is surrounded by water molecules like this. In between water and the solutes, interactions will be formed. Clear? That means solute and, in other words, solute and solvent become homogeneous. Or they go homogenized. Clear? Similarly, the polar molecule can dissolve in water. Likewise, ionic substance can also dissolve in water. Ionic substance may also dissolve in water. They are also, imagine these surround water molecules, make interactions with these ionic substance, and its water molecules surround the ionic substance. This polarity of water, water acts as a good solvent. Water acts as a good solvent, which is a versatile solvent due to its polarity. Water acts as a good solvent due to its polarity. Polarity ka theka me the solvent yaadde. Clear? So due to its polarity, it can make interactions with another solute. Due to its polarity, it can make interaction with ionic substance or ionic solute. Also, due to its polarity, water can make interactions with a substance with both polar and ionic properties. Clear? Therefore, due to the polarity of water, polar solutes, ionic solutes, and solutes in both polar and ionic regions can dissolve in water. During this, water molecules make interactions with the solute. And water molecules surround the solute molecules. Clear? Most, mainly hydrogen bonds can be formed. Hydrogen bonds are in the pool. Substance can dissolve in water, no interactions are in the pool. Netan, aravagi oil dam avagi separate la, tino me paani thode, you know. Versatility as a solvent. This ability is given to water due to polarity. So, online kula thiyagam, this ability is given due to the polarity. Therefore, me balanda polar molecules. Example, glucose. Remember the examples. In ionic compounds like sodium chloride. And molecules with both polar and ionic regions like lysozyme. This lysozyme is an enzyme. Lysozyme is an enzyme. Can dissolve in water. Because water molecules surround each of the solid molecule and form hydrogen bonds with them. Mainly hydrogen bonds will be formed. Sometimes some other interactions, but hydrogen bonds can be formed. And finally, it says solubility depends on the polarity and not in their ionic nature. That means different types of molecules dissolve in water not due to their ionic nature. Different substances, polar molecules, ionic molecules, as well as solutes with both polar and ionic regions, make interactions with water due to polarity of water. Therefore, solubility depends on the polarity, not in the ionic nature. So within this space, we can show what happens when solute dissolves in water. We will consider ionic substance, more familiar sodium chloride. Imagine this is sodium ions. When sodium ions dissolve in water, what happened? In water molecules. Water molecules, the methane is water molecules. These are the water molecules.
ඔන්න let's say these are water molecules මේ ඉතින් හිතන්නේ ඔක්සිජන් කියලා let's say this is oxygen and here oxygen is negatively charged you know oxygen is negatively charged මේ negatively charged oxygen make interactions with positively charged sodium then water molecules surround the sodium ions this is what happens Then water molecules around the sodium ions and make interaction. These are not hydrogen bonds because hydrogen bonds can't be formed with sodium ions. But with the chloride, chloride ions also dissolve in water. That means when you put sodium chloride into water, sodium ions and chloride ions are separated. This is how sodium is arranged. And chloride also arrange like this. Then I mean, imagine these are the water molecules. Then up with the methane water molecules. Then here, middle oxygen, then these are the hydrogen atoms, so positively charged hydrogen, positively charged hydrogen. Then it make interactions with the positively charged hydrogen. Oh, no, interactions. Positively charged hydrogen attracted to chloride. Then these are hydrogen. Hemothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymothymoth
to show what happened when solute dissolve in water. That's about water. What the name water you write? So now memorize their contents with understanding. Mainly you should focus on the property, its role, and the example. Those are the three main things discussed in the section. Clear? It describes how different properties of water contribute in maintaining life. The property, its role, and the example should be perfectly known with the understanding. Hari denan kattiye then theruna ne ena adara api odrin nawath ara today we will stop here. Now come to the paper discussion on Sunday paper discussion ekata enda. Last day also we discussed two structured essays. This day I gave homework. I put that essay in the group ek essay topic ekak damma eda eka balanda naththan ai paramayen ahanda. We will discuss that essay and also we will do some MCQs. I will send a small MCQ paper on Sunday. Then we can discuss those at Sunday night. Sunday night will put up a lot of pull up. Do those questions as well. It is essential. Doing questions is very essential from the beginning. Then you can learn how to write answers, how to address these questions. It is very essential. So come to the paper class as well. Paper class is the minimum end. I will never charge for any negative. දෙකම එකයි ඒකින්ද එකට එන්න අපි ඇඩිෂනලි පේපර්ස් ටිකක් විතර ලියන්න පුළුවන්. ඒ ටයිම් එක තියලා තියාගන්න ෆ්‍රී මොකද අපිට දැන් පේපර් ලියන්න කොහොමද දවසක් තියෙන්නේ. අපිට ඉස්සරහට දිගින් දැන් ඔතන දැනට අපි චුට්ටක් ඉගෙනගෙන තියෙන හින්දා පොඩි පොඩි ඒවා තමයි ලියන්නේ. ඉස්සරහට අපිට පේපර් ක්ලාස් පේපර් ටයිම් එකේදී ලොකු පේපර්ස් උනාත් ලියන්න පුළුවන්. ටික කාලයක් ගියාට පස්සේ. ඒක හින්දා මුලින්දම පොඩ පොඩ ක්වෙස්චන්ස් කරන් යම්. ඒක එතකොට හෙල්ප්ෆුල්. හරිනේ. එහෙනම් අදටදී නැවතුණා. ගුඩ් නයිට්. ඊළඟ දවසේ හම්බෙමු. පාඩම් කරන්න. ඊළඟ දවසේ හම්බෙමු.